absolutely watch this entire video. Don't skip a single section. You will regret missing what I have to share today. I am really excited about this content today because there's something that I figured out recently that's going to absolutely revolutionize how you type on your computer. Now, I am a fairly fast talker, a fairly fast typer, and a fast reader. I average about 400 words per minute reading. I can type roughly 50 to 60 words per minute, and I speak in between 150 and 200 words per minute. So it's very, very clear that the bottleneck, the part that slows us down the most, is our typing speed. If you can read about an average of 300 to 500 words per minute, which is very normal, then that's how much you understand. That's how your brain thinks, the speed at which it comprehends. Now, my typing speed, if it's 50 words per minute with good accuracy, and my reading comprehension is 400 words per minute, that means that I type 1/8 of the speed that I think. That is trudging through mud. Absolutely not the right way to do things. Now, if I can talk 200 words a minute pretty comfortably, well, that's four times the speed of my typing speed when I'm straining to type fast. Talking is not a straining activity for most of us. It's actually very natural. Some of us even do it every day. So I want to show you the world's fastest typist. This is a guy, Mythical Rocket. All right, and here's the fastest talker in the world.
It will shock you to know that I finished reading 1,679 pages book in 2 seconds. Yes, 2 seconds.
Do you know what 2 seconds is? That's one
and then two.
Yeah.
Yes. Go on.
But like it was fast, so you didn't know.
What did you just
It's because I'm fast.
You are fast. That's what? What did you want to tell me? You just finished reading all those books.
Yeah, it's because I'm fast.
Really enjoy the last video of the guy reading so quickly. It's truly remarkable talent. Okay, so here, what we're going to do is I'm going to show you my process for creating these different text documents, and then we are not going to be correcting them inside of Microsoft Word or wherever. And we're going to be using a specific dictation mode. We're not going to be using the Windows plus H Cortana dictation because it stops listening when you're done with a phrase. We want to continue listening and continue going. So what we're going to do is we're going to read this section right here, then copy it over into ChatGPT, and we are going to modify ChatGPT into something called TeachGPT. And we're going to do this with a prompt, and it will do all of our punctuation, it will fix our grammatical errors, and it will correct and suggest words for us to replace ones that may have been heard wrong by the dictation software. This is really, really cool. All right, so we're going to click on the dictate button. You can use voice access. Also, voice access works without the internet. If you have no internet, you can use the voice access function or dictate here, but both of them work quite well. Speed reading world records claims have been controversial. How would Stephen Bird from the United States has claimed to be a Guinness World Record holder for fast reading with a speed of 25,000 words per minute? And Maria Teresa Calderon from the Philippines claims to have earned the Guinness World Record for world's fastest reader at 80,000 words per minute, reading speed, and 100% comprehension. All right, so this is pretty good. Actually, very good. Speedring World Backers claims to have been controversial. So what we're going to do is we're going to take this. Now, I read very fast and actually very complicated content. So names and everything in here, the fact that it got Maria Teresa Calderon accurately and spelled it correct is really phenomenal to me. Okay, so let's jump over to here. This is our Teach GPT. I'm going to paste right here and click enter. So now you'll notice that it's taken words that it thinks might need correction and it's made them bold. So let's say we've gone through this, and what we're going to do, I'm going to show you another fun little trick. So I'm pressing this shift click button right here. This is selecting all of the text. Now I'm pressing the right click one, and we're doing read aloud.
Speed reading world record claims have been controversial. Howard Steven Berg from the United States is claiming to be a Guinness World Record holder for fast reading with a speed of 25,000 words per minute, and Maria Teresa Calderon from the Philippines claims to have earned the Guinness World Record for the world's fastest reader with a reading speed of 80,000 words per minute and 100% comprehension.
Okay, now we're going to type the word apply. We'll turn on voice access. Voice access, wake up. Apply. Enter. Notice that all of the bold words have become unbold, and we're going to click here on this copy. We can create buttons on this panel here if we want to turn on and off the mode here. So let's see, Alt-Shift-B toggles this on and off so we can really easily start and stop listening. Delete. Copy. Paste. And go into Word Options, Advanced, and choose Keep Text Only when pasting from other programs. This will save us some time. All right, so let's undo this. So what I really like about this is this has fixed any grammatical issues, it's applied punctuation, it's changed any spelling to be the correct spelling, and let's do this a sloppy version. So what we are going to do here is we are going to type a sloppy text section here and show how well the chat GPT, teach GPT can actually fix errors. All right, so going to copy this over, and we've got errors right here, right here, right here. This should be combined. This is spelled wrong, and we're going to put it over into Chat GPT. Okay, paste. So what we're going to do here is we're going to type a sloppy text section here and show how well the Chat GPT, Tech GPT, can actually fix errors. No, I've corrected the typo here to here, and also fixed show to show and wahoo to how. Additionally, I added missing spaces, capitalized the acronym GPT and ChatGPT, and provided the alternative name TechGPT in parentheses. Okay, we'll say apply. So what we're going to do here is we're going to type a sloppy text section here and show how well the ChatGPT TechGPT can actually fix errors. This is without changing the meaning, or this needed an A in it. This is actually better content than what we put into it. And it's really a fantastic tool. So if you are a student or if you're trying to write, this is a really, really, really good way to write without cheating. And I don't want to say that using ChatGPT to create content is cheating, but a lot of us don't want that. We want to create our own content. We don't want to do all of the laborsome editing, all the laborsome formatting, all that stuff. We just want that part to be done and we're hiring out other people, or we're simply not doing the work because we're concerned that it will take too long because of a lot of these different processes. Okay, so use this, share this. All right, so how do you set up this grammar check, teach GPT inside of ChatGPT? Well, you can do this a couple different ways. I recommend doing it inside of ChatGPT instead of Bing, because this will keep track and you can continue to use it. So what we're going to do is we're going to create a new chat. I'm going to use key press OSD. That's this up here to expand this out. I'll have TeachGPT as well as a handful of other bots that I've created inside of the members area, where I'll be teaching you how to be a better student, learn faster, more with less effort, retain more information, and enjoy the process a whole lot more without being confined into a office, a desk, or somewhere uncomfortable. All right, you guys, thank you so much for watching. If you haven't subscribed yet and you like this content, please do that right now. Until next time, stay creative and have a wonderful day.